table, YouTube. In which we have once in a twice a sentence, lo is so. Will not be an end. And next to it, Tero from Ishmael. Let us see very interesting Medrash 2000 years ago, which says the following. One, his name is called Ishmael. By the way, Ishmael is in future tense, and it should be written Ishmael, because of the idea of his name was that God listened to his prayer. So he said, as his goal of Ishmael to cause the Holy One, blessed be he, to hear the groaning of the people of Israel for what the sons of Ishmael will do to them in the end, in the land, in the end of days. Amazingly, 2,000 years ago, yeah, this is a Midrash written 2,000 years ago, Rabbi Eliezer observes the events that are destined to be at the end of days. It's unbelievable that at that time we thought that Ishmael at that time were not even a nation, didn't far away from being what they are today. Nevertheless, he could see it clearly that this is going on, and this is why it's called Ishmael in future, that indicates that the Arabs will do so many troubles to Jews, they will have repent and will do Shuva in the end. This is the purpose of it. So Ishmael, the purpose of all these troubles that the Arabs are doing to Jews is to cause them to repent, to do Shuva. Now let us see the verse.
So this is really the table that you are going to see now. Now, it is amazing how it fits with, unfortunately, there's no end to tell, you know. 100 times, I think more than 100 times, ministers of defense said, no more tell, we are going to fight it. No, they will not be able to fight it. Unfortunately, we see today, it is such a, unfortunately, such a precious man, you know, everyone knows about him, and really very strong, even a black belt. But unfortunately, you know, it's difficult. One comes from the back, you cannot do anything. So all this is very important, really, that everything fits with what the Torah said. That this terror, you know, this is the work of Ishmael, these cruel people, these wild beasts, you know, Bere Adam, as they are calling, this is the name of them. And exactly what is written, that it's called Ishmael, you can see it, Ishmael in future. God will listen to the prayers, to the crying of Jews because of him. This is purpose, Ishmael, to bring Jews to repent, what we can do. This was the Rabbi tell us more than 1,000 years ago. This is what Torah says. This was a blessing to Ishmael. So unfortunately, yeah, this is no end to terror unless Jews will do Tshuva. So let us see now the appearance of what we saw before, clearly about, unfortunately, no end to the terror. So this was behavior, really, it will not end, it will not be end, with evil it is law, yes, so it will not be end. To the tell, it can come in one center, but it's the best meeting. That law yet all will not end this terror. And unfortunately, because they are really pushed by Iran, they push the Amalekite, unbelievable Amalekite. Hamas, those who are carrying good, and this evil force, the heavenly ministers of the Amalekite, comes here also in small skip. And the Arabs, since we know quite well who are behind all this, the Arabs, unfortunately, Hamas, you can see all the Fatah, all of them really appears here once in the Torah. And then what we see more is this is the Amalekite, the snake, yeah. And this is what the Torah says, it's by the way minimal skip of Ishmael. I mean, it appears as a name, but in a skip is a minimum in the Torah, and it's like a message to Israel, don't desecrate, don't desecrate the Shabbos, don't desecrate the holiness and sanctity of men and women. Yeah, we call it Otamutus, then you will not die. Unfortunately, you know, Israel is written that Jews are guaranteed one to the others, you know, that sometimes righteous people are killed, died because of, you know, kind of atonement, who knows what is going on. But the most important thing is for us, that this is what the Torah says. Yeah, he's a wild Pere Adam, wild man, wild beast, really. And this is how they behave, you know, only to kill. And you know, they themselves say their purpose is to kill Jews. This is what they said clearly. They believe that once they kill, murder Jews, they have a part in the world to come. Unfortunately, this is very difficult to fight. You can fight only with belief, with faith. But this is the situation. So as we saw today, such really terrible tragedy of a man, father to four, really were killed in such a brutal way. And this is the teaching for us now before the Day of Atonement. You know, we have to know, you have to repent, to do tshuva. And this tshuva, repentance, will help us to get rid of this really beast, you know, terrorist. Because otherwise, you know, if you carry on to desecrate the Shabbat, so God said, "Lo tachalelu, v'lo tamut," don't desecrate, and then you will not die. And desecrating the Shabbos, desecrating the holiness and sanctity of men and women, homosexualism, all these things made cross, not very cross. The Torah says this, yeah? Wrath and anger comes because of all these things. What we can do, it is not what we say, the Torah says. So let us hope that really all these terrible events which are happening will bring us to repent, to realize that all these evil forces, the Amalekites and the heavenly minister of the Samael, to do with the left also, because it's powers against the Torah, against God. And this is why we suffer from the Hamas.